Меня зовут Арника, and that's pretty much my end of my Russian. But we are today mostly to speak not about me, maybe a bit, but that test that can be written by themselves, almost themselves. A bit about me. I'm a part of Polish Testing Board. It's a big representative here. Two guys already speak here. Also, I'm a master engineer in computer science. In tester, as a tester, over 10 years already. Last year, I've got nomination and then the award of Exploratory Tester of the Year for the contents of Testing Heroes. And additionally, I also shoot a bit. And I was 2 years in a row in a finals for the sports rifle competition. But that's all about me. What I will be talking about is the model-based testing, what it's coming from, what's the idea behind it, what tools can we use for that, how the process of creation such a model and then test cases looks like, what are the possibilities, and is it useful or not. It started like many things, so on the university, with one paper by guys called Ofut and however to spell it. But these guys presented a paper about using UML collaboration diagrams for static checking and test generation. So for automatic test generation out of UML diagrams. And why would we need and want to generate test cases automatically? So, well, creating test cases is mostly time consuming. Like, depends on the source, it's 50 up to even 70% of time of a tester to create and prepare all the test cases. And if we have a big team, it's uneven because we have like junior tester who is writing differently. Sometimes we don't have a standard for writing those test cases. So some are logical, some are high level, some low level. So it's hard to do the even test cases. So even if we have coverage, it's not always tested in the same way. And also sometimes, depending on how you work, it's hard to measure, like to track to requirements and measure and check the coverage. Like in one of my projects, we had 1,500 of test cases, so 1,500. And after doing, because finally we've got time to review all those test cases and see if they're really useful, and turns out, and out of this 1,500, only 500 were useful. The rest was obsolete. So it wasn't tracked to the requirements. Requirements were changing. So it's unmeasurable sometimes. So how can we solve those problems? What is solution? For time, so we have time issue, time consuming. We have the consistency issue, and we have the requirements cover issue. With model-based testing, the idea is to have automated test case generation, so automate, do it faster than us testers. Consistency, since one mechanism is generating all the test cases, they are consistent. And in this approach, models equal specification, so we know how the cover looks like. What's the general idea? So we have requirements. Oh, even working. In the standard way, we are creating the test case specification, then creating the test cases. But we also can do a model out of those requirements and then generate test cases out of its model. Then, of course, we can do scripts, the automated ones, and put it to test the system under test. It can be done in two ways. So it can be online and offline. Offline means that we first generate the test set of test cases and then put it to test the system under test. Online, that we generate it on the fly. So while we are testing, while we are working on the system, the test cases are generated on the fly. And how is it different from the test automation? In this approach, we are not automating the already existing scripts, but we are automating the generation of the test cases. So preparing the scenarios, preparing the cases. We are focusing on a model. How the model looks like, I will show you in a minute. So actual use of application, because we have to model how our systems behave, how does it look like, and it's much easier to maintain since we are not maintaining 1,000 test cases. We are maintaining only the model which generates the test cases. We are changing only the model and test cases are regenerated again. If it comes to tools, as you see, it's only part of it. It's a bunch of them, but since it started as a paper, as an academic approach, there is a lot of tools that were done for the studies, for the one paper, and they are not maintained anymore. So you don't have support for them. There are some that were open source and are supported, like GraphWalker, very nice one. But this requires also not only modeling skill, but also the coding skill. And there are also like Matello or Testcas. There are commercial solutions, and few of them had demo version, not anymore because I wanted to show one commercial, but you have to buy it for like few hundred euro or something like that. So it is a lot of tools, but it's very hard to find one suitable for you. So I will show you how it looks in one tool. It's not my laptop, so I have screens on the demo, so it's not live demo. This tool I'm showing here is called Mista. It's open source one, but it was academic, so not supported anymore, but still it's working pretty good and you can work on that. So first we have configuration, how we will be covering our model. We have the state coverage, depth coverage, reliability tree, so different approaches to cover our model. Then we can choose what version of test we want to. We can put in Java unit and generate automatically, and a lot of languages. And then under those options, we also have, like for Selenium, we have Firefox and Internet Explorer driver. After configuration, we are doing the model. It's pretty obvious and simple one. So there's this web page with the turn on, turn off only button. So we are modeling what are the states and what are the actions on this web page system. Of course, for the real life system, it will be much bigger, but we are modeling it just for clicking and choosing the options, what to put on this canvas and only putting the initial state. Then we have to connect it to the system. So we are describing those actions. What is the label of that model? How it is covered? And where is this page that we will be testing? If you look on the internet for Mista, you will find this page with examples when you can practice this approach. And then we are generating test cases. For Java, simply by testing, generate test cases, we have like that covered in JUnit. For the same model, without changing anything, only this configuration and choosing Selenium, we have tests like that that are saved in the format that can be read by Selenium. The models in different tools you can model in different ways. As it begins from the UML, you can just create UML model and then generate test cases out of this model. And the commercial solutions also have ability to import those test cases directly for Jira or Team Foundation server or Quality Center. So just create out of model, import it to Selenium, and you have like 200 of test cases. You can also use Gherkin syntax. This is called for test, like the number for test dot io, I think, and it's online tool when you can generate a model in a Gherkin. So we can use the Gherkin user stories for generating test cases. And the model also can be created as a code. But it's strange to do a code to generate test cases to test a code. But maybe it's useful for some people. Also, some twist on that, as we have mutation testing, also we can mutate the model to generate not only the happy path, but also the negative scenarios, the mutated scenarios. So what are the advantages if you would like to use the model-based testing approach? We have to understand our system very thoroughly, in very detailed way, to know how it works, to model the system. We can find the bugs early, because if we will be doing the model out of requirements, then we saw that something's wrong in the requirement. For example, we do the state machine diagram to create the model, and we see that something is not covered, or we have like blank spot there. As our model grows, also our test case suite grows. We can generate endless tests, so a lot of them, a lot of options, but then do we need all of them? It's up to us testers to verify. We can provide better coverage with a lot of those tests and a few more of advantages, but also nothing is green, only green. We have also disadvantages, which is we need the skill of modeling. We have a lot of skills to know how to model the system. So maybe it's not for us testers. Maybe we can work with the analysts who are creating UMLs and work together to create those models. We need expertise in those tools. Not every of them is very user-friendly. I tried like 10 of them. As with every automation, initial effort, if it comes to cost and time, it's very high, because we have to introduce the tool, find the tool properly, learn the tool. Changes in the model, if we change something, the outcome can be that our test set will be completely different, and it's not always good. And our test cases will be tightly coupled with the model. So everything depends on the model. If we do something wrong in this only point of contact, the only model, then the outcome can also be influenced. As a summary, as I'm going out of time, it requires new skill from us testers, so modeling. We need additional time and effort to investigate this option, to learn it. But the approach can be that it can be supplementary, that we are will be not only basing on the model, but we can do our manual test case design and then also generate some test cases with this approach, because then we can focus on how the system works, how the model of the system looks like, and of course it's necessary, as with every tool, to choose the one that suits your needs, and it's not easy, as not every of them has a demo version. Большое спасибо.
Arika, thank you for your presentation. It's really great, and your tool is awesome. Two questions. First one, if I got you correctly, it's a kind of end-to-end testing using Selenium. Why so many languages for code generation?
Because it depends how your system is created. If you have .NET technology, then you can generate your unit test with that, with the end unit version.
Just to make it universal. Okay,
yeah,
I got
just
it.
To fit your system.
And the second question, do you have any long running plans on replacing proprietary parts of the system and maybe making it open source?
Again?
Okay, you are relying on some open source projects and on proprietary,
yeah,
which is have cost. Do you have any plans on replacing proprietary parts and making it entire open source and your?
Not right now.
Okay, thank you.
Any questions?
Hi, thanks for your report. So my question is more about practice. So do you try this approach on real project or not? First question.
Yeah, I tried. Not the one I'm working. Not in my company, my big company. But I have also side projects and tried there with the open source, and just to practice this approach. And it was really helpful. I've got the test cases I didn't think of when I was doing it manually, so it was helpful in this approach. But it was only a web page, a small one, so I didn't try it for a like big company. But I know that, for example, Spotify is using this approach. I don't know which tool.
Okay, so second question related to previous one. So did you have other automated tests for your small project, which was written by you manually? Can you compare how many time needs to run manual written tests and generated tests?
It's this small project. It was half and half. If it comes to manual tests and this automatically generated tests.
Sorry. I mean, so you can have automated tests, which was automated, automatically generated. I mean, and for the same project, you maybe had automated tests, which you write yourself using some language.
Oh, so no, I didn't have the automated tests written by myself.
you start with this approach.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks.
Thanks. There was another person, I think, there.
No time, no please.
Time. Sorry. I will stay a bit longer so you can ask just directly the question.
Choose a favorite question, please.
Oh God. There was two questions, right? So I've got two cards and it's for you.